Hey yo, hey! This is another episode. This is the episode. I always call it the '80s bitch episode. I don't know what to call it. It's something technical, but with my DVR just has the dates on it. And because going to Logo's website and actually get the title is too beyond. It's below me at this point. I'm just stringing it. You know, that's what I do. That's what I do. So hey, we have this new lower light situation going on, right? It is what it is. It allows me not to really care what's going on with, this is not Lola, this is Evita. I call her Evita. Because Evita literally was just like balled up on the floor. Because I don't respect anything. You know, you would think that I would. Because underneath here, I'm all cornrowed out like, you know, Queen Latifah in Set It Off. But I wanted to bring Evita, and I'm excited to bring it to you. So, you know, I don't know if it's because I'm over having the show back or what, or I'm just over having all these group challenges, but I'm really over it. And I'm over it because you don't really get to see them shine on their own. You really see them, how they interact with other individuals. And unless I didn't catch the typo, this isn't for groups. This is a queen to be America's next drag superstar. So the way they work in groups, it makes you go, what? Like, I've changed a lot of opinions on them. Like, my top three are still there, like Bob, Kimchi, Naomi. But it's like, I really didn't like Bob this episode. Not like I normally do. I saw a rough, I didn't like her. I didn't hate her, but I didn't really, like, I'm not fiending for her. Like, if she would have lip sync, I would be like, oh, really? Okay. Shady babies. He'll interrupt. And, like, it makes me, like, I liked the girl, Naisha, whatever her name is, the one that came and gone. I liked her attitude, and I like her look. And then it's like, Naomi. I love Naomi. But her look on the show, out of drag, is different than the look that I grew to get accustomed to her with now at drag. So I'm like, I don't like all that hair. I want to see you looking like the designer, the, you know, Kardashian designer boy. But I'm shallow. So that's another thing. I just can't. My perceptions. I've always had a rough perception of Acid Betty. Because she has been rough. But now I, like last week, I hated her. And this week I was like, I don't like you. But at a certain level, I have to respect your shade. Like, I'm like, I wouldn't have said that. But the fact that you did makes me feel like I can fuck with you. That's where I'm at right now. You know, last week, and the last couple of weeks, let's get it real, was poor Kimchi. Poor Kimchi can't do anything. She can't even breathe right. And then she goes out there and she slays it. And then this week was, you know, Chi-Chi. Like, last week was too, also. But then she slays it. They set them up to make you feel sorry for it. And then they slay. Even though Kimchi, I mean, Chi-Chi, the names are too close. Chi-Chi went out there. And she didn't do too good with the challenge. I thought she did good with the challenge. But I guess I didn't see what they wanted to see. But I thought she did okay. But that lip sync performance, Chow Me Chow, Honey child, when they, I'm stepping ahead, but so it to me it's troubling. So next week, of course, we get to see them in the Shade Game. No, it's Snatch Game. It's really literally the Shade Game because they're shading themselves by the poor performances they do. But this year should be okay, I guess. I'm not looking forward to it too much because I've been let down for years with that shit. But I feel good about it because, honestly, we're going to do this. We know Derek Barry is going to do Britney. She'll do her shit. She'll survive this week. And next week, she'll be gone. Because this is the point of having her there. To do her Shade Snatch Game, and then, boom, she's gone. So, I don't know. Mama don't know anymore. I'm still into it. But, you know, I'm just watching and I see stuff and I see how they set stuff up. And I'm like, is this on purpose? Just like last week. I didn't talk about it because I was sick as a dog last week. But the fact that they literally had them on roller skates, that fucked me up for days. Like, I was like, what? Because first of all, I was like, Kimchi can't walk. And they gonna make her skate? Like, in a dress? But then I was like, you know, you had to think about it. They had to know the sizes. And before you go on the show, in my mind, you know things of the competition. So, you know what you're gonna do. So, practice. So then maybe they had a chance to practice. Because only one of them really did really, really bad. And she did bad, but she went out over her overall look last week. Because Cynthia was just like, bitch, what? You look like, I don't want to get into it. I don't want to offend anybody. But I was just like, how do they do that? And then, you know, the first episode, Fifi, it's too many names that match and rhyme, but Fifi was on Twitter talking about the situation between her and Jiggly and how they made Jiggly say certain things to pump up the little situation. And I'm like, for whatever reason, I never thought that would happen because, you know, I live in a fairy tale land and all of this is real. To me, this is all real. So when I see this and I see constantly them setting up certain individuals to do in their mind bad and they get out there and they kill shit, I'm like, what was the point of the last 45 minutes crying over something? If you get out there and you do it like your life depended on it, magically. The fact that we all know what Kimchi's troubles are. And they all are highlighted throughout almost every episode. And she gets out there and she kills. Is it because she's... Nah, I don't want to say anything. I'm very stereotypical, okay? I'm racist. But it's because she's... You know what I'm going to say. I don't like to say it. It's in your mind. You... Okay. Is it because of that? I want to say something else about fried chicken and rib comment and watermelon comment. But I won't do that. But you know what I'm talking about. So it's just like, it's weird and odd for me. But it is what it is. This episode went down. Oh, this lip sync. Oh my God. So first of all, Nanasia is gorgeous. She did good with the runway. In my mind, she did good, you know? She brought it to be kicked off, came back, and then, you know, bottom again. She brought it. But the minute they put her in that ring, I'll call it a ring because it was definitely a boxing match. When they put her in that ring with Chi-Chi, and I was like, wait a minute. You're going to put this pageant queen up against down south wonder of the world, and you think that the down south turkey bone gutter is not going to win? It was like, it was at the point where I didn't want to watch. But I had to because I was like, is she about to, who was that girl? Dita Ritz? Is she about to, no. Is she about to Trinity? Them bitches. You know how Trinity was on the bottom four, the bottom two, and she would go and lip sync for her life and knock bitches off one by one by one. And it was like, don't go up against that bitch. And I was like, is she about to start this trend? Because I was threatened. Like, I don't even feel like we saw half of what she can do. She just gave you a little light work. Just a little bit of, oh, okay, well, y'all gonna put me in right now? I just do a little bit for you. That's all that was. I feel like to put her out of this competition, you're going to really put her out. Like, she's going to have to be so many lip syncs that her ankles hurt. Okay. Knees busted. She has to show something because did you see those flips? Did you see that? Did you see like I saw? Did you see the fact that I'm new to this wig life, and I don't even like going outside when I'm out in public with the wig, with wind, okay? I don't even like wind blowing. Did you see the way she was flipping the hair around? I was like, give it to her just on that. Give her the championship on that. She was wonderful. But, you know, I'm excited. We do that, Snatch Game next week, and it'll be okay, hopefully. Hopefully girls will come strong. You know, we saw glimpses of people they're doing. And, you know, Thori would probably kill it. And, you know, Derek Berry would. I'm curious to see who the others will be. Like Naomi or whatever. But, not Naomi. Kimchi, whatever. You know, bitch, whatever. I'm ready for them to sign on their own. The moral of this whole video is I'm ready for them to stand on their own. I'm sick of this group shit. I want to see them do what they have to do to survive. I don't want to see them relying on other people's ideas and concepts and rivalries. I guess I'm done. And we got with No Shady Baby. He's running around. Bye.